But men chose darkness instead of the light.
Sons will lose their lives, avenging the deaths of their fathers. But vengeance belongs to the Lord. Put your faith in him.
He is silent.
His law is not silent. That is where you will find your answers. Not in this. Now enough talk. Let us continue with our studies. His law is perfect, and on his law we must meditate day and night. Shema Yisrael, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai.
Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, soul, and with all your might.
Shema!
Adonai, let him go. Again.
Shema Yisrael, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad.
The Lord has bared his holy arm.
Keepers of the law, you want wander in the wilderness like a crazy person.
And you teach nothing but lies.
Who are you to instruct us?
The people that come to me seek forgiveness in their hearts and in their spirits. I baptize them in water as a symbol. But he who comes after shall baptize them in the Holy Spirit, and every believer shall be chopped down and thrown into the fire.
I want to be washing the river.
I know him. He's a tax collector.
What shall I do?
Only collect that which you are ordered. No more.
Hey, you! What about us?
What must we do to be saved?
Content with your wages.
But they are Romans. Their sins are greater than ours.
But he who comes after will bring hope. He will forgive us of our sins if we seek him with our whole hearts.
Yes, I want this help. I want this forgiveness.
Behold, the Lamb of God takes away the sin of the world. Oh,
attempted to use me in this august body for your own gain. I upheld my part of the agreement. The Sanhedrin released their duty. Perhaps your Jesus.
No! Do not speak his name! Please, help me! I am lost!
What is that to us? You were intent on this action, and the light you have been following has been extinguished. You created this darkness, now live in it.
Where can I run? Who will befriend me now? I can never rid myself of this menace! Have my deeds put an end to peace for my soul? Oh, you demons of the dark! You haunt me. You have my soul! What is left for me but to deliver to you my life!
Thank you.
Father, forgive them. They know not what they do.
Yeah. of death, not even a grave. Because what did you come to do? You come to save us. You came on a rescue mission. Because when God created man, he put him in a perfect place. There was no sin, there was nothing. And then sin entered into the world through Adam and Eve and broke their relationship with God. No longer did they walk with God. In fact, they hid from God. And God ran them out of the garden. And God, in that encounter with the serpent, there's that prophecy said, one day, he will crush the head of the serpent. Though the serpent will bruise his heel. And even in Genesis chapter 3, verse 15, it looks all the way to what we just saw. The day when Jesus would suffer and die. And yes, his bruise was healed. He was crucified. But then he walked out of the grave and destroyed the powers of death and darkness. So the question is, do you believe in Jesus? Are you following Jesus Christ? Nobody has ever done that for you. Nobody's ever loved you that way. Nobody's ever taken your place on a cross. That was our cross. He didn't die for his sin. He died for ours. That was our cross. Those beatings were ours. And that crown of thorns should have been on our head. But he came to take our place so that we might be forgiven. And he invites us to follow him. He invites us to believe. And tonight I believe that some of you have come to that moment of doing just that. How in the world could you hear the story, see the story, and experience it like we did tonight, and then walk out and still doubt or still live life on your own? No, I think it's time to believe. I think it's time to say there's only one man who went to a cross and went to a grave and walked out of a grave for me. I'm following that man. His name is Jesus Christ. So what does it mean to follow Christ? It means to first trust him. It means to turn to him and to ask him to come and to fill your life. It means to turn from yourself and quit trusting yourself. And turn and say, Jesus, I trust you.